judge it on me, that's on me, I'm conceited. Treaty, nah, that ain't how we treat it. This right here sound like a three-peat. I put the d*** in, it sound like I'm knee-deep. I'm like, oh, you too needy. Me and HB going Juvie and BG. They gotta put my face on the box of Wheaties. I'm praying for whoever think they competed. Salute when you see me. That's all he ever, so that's how you greet me. I'm going TM101 cheesy. And plus they got D2 on repeat. I'm with the love of my life for like 3 weeks, cause that's all I needed. She wanna go on a trip or retreat, but I'm sorry, I never retreated. I set the bar so high that you might as well leave it. I'm going undefeated. I've broken the system, had to breach it. That's mission impossible, mission completed.
Salute when you see me, oh yeah. I got the heart of a god and a genie. I want you to love me, I want you to need me. When I this face is feeding. I gotta get back to the hood. I remember when I was the needy. Clean me up, baby, squeaky. She fell in love, deeply. Sleepy, they like what I say, they repeat me. Look, all this money I be spending on babies. That's why you gotta show me when you see me.
The saying goes, there's a first time for everything. And for Russell Wilson, today's his first game ever at U.S. Bank Stadium. Will the Vikings give him a rude introduction? Find out next on EA Sports.
A very warm day outside by Minnesota standards, but then again, it is still summer. Either way, the AC is working just fine at U.S. Bank Stadium in the Twin Cities. The scene a short time ago, this crowd decked out in purple, and they were in full roar as their guys burst out of the locker room. We're ready for football, folks, as the Vikings get set to do battle with Russell Wilson and the Seattle Seahawks. Hi again, everyone. Brandon Garth alongside Charles Davis. And Charles, you look at this Vikings ball club. It's an early test here after two losses to start the season and a game they probably really need.
Obviously, no way do they want to get to 4-3. Not many teams make the playoffs with that kind of a start.
Meanwhile, for our visitors, the Seahawks, it's been a great start to the season. Back-to-back wins to begin the campaign.
Yeah, you don't want to get too excited. There's still a lot of season to go, but they've come out playing good fundamental football, and that might carry them a long way.
Kickoff will not be returned, as that will be a touchback. The Minnesota offense ready to go to work here. Their quarterback in his 10th season overall now, and fourth as a Viking, Kirk Cousins.
And I saw that he had an interesting quote in the research packet that we had after last week's game. It's all on me now. I've got to lead my team and find a way for us to win a game. 0-2, but they're at home. I guess he's going to try and find a way to get the home crowd involved early.
Now the first carry for Dalvin Cook. And not much to speak of. Call it a 1 yard gain up to the 26. Here's 2nd and 9, just a yard on that last run. Cousins gives way to Cook. And they're able to get this one across the 35.
And that's why Dalvin Cook is the Minnesota Vikings feature back. You put the ball in his hands, good things happen. 2nd in the NFL last year in rushing with 1,557 yards, and that's now back-to-back 1,000-yard seasons with 30 combined total touchdowns. What a player is Dalvin Cook.
Following the good run by Cook, here's another 1st and 10. Now a handoff here to his running back. Solid move, but he's corralled just beyond the 40. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a 2nd and 3. 1st carry for the Boise State Bronco, Alexander Mattison. And he is swallowed up right at the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain that time, as it's going to leave him with a 3rd and about 3 to go.
Come on, come on.
it. Here's Cook. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. It's a gain of 11 as the Vikings pick up the first. Defense had a chance to get off the field here in the opening drive, couldn't do it.
I know that we go into these meetings with coaches, and sometimes maybe we can get, you know, a little bit numb because they're always going to talk about how important third down is, aren't they? Offense and defense. In this case, one capitalized, and the other, as you said, had a chance to get off the field and didn't get it done.
So from Seahawk territory now, it's first and 10 at the 46. On the carry, it's Cook. Trying to run inside, but nothing there. Bobby Wagner, the all-pro, in on the tackle. So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. Give to Cook out of the gun. He'll get only a couple down to the 44. Here comes the seventh play of this opening drive. They've moved it well, but here's third down. Here's Cousins. And that is incomplete. So on fourth down, Britton Colquitt on a punt. Back deep for the Seahawks, Tyler Lockett. And he punted three times in the loss last week as he sends this one away. And this will be up to the ruling of the side judge here. He says it crossed out of bounds at the 16-yard line. Seattle's offense ready to go here for the first time, and leading them is the 7-time Pro Bowler. In his 10th year now in the NFL, Russell Wilson.
And he's had good success here already this season throwing the football. 6 touchdown passes in his 2 games. He's really got this offense playing with a lot of confidence, trying to establish themselves early as a Super Bowl contender.
Now Wilson on first down. In trouble here, and down he goes. Back at the 8-yard line. But Danielle Hunter, he's the one who gets in there and brings him down to the ground.
Didn't have the greatest field position to start, did they? And now, after this sack, it's way, way worse.
And right off the bat, first play of the game. Well behind the sticks here with a second and 18. And he's going to be taken down shy of the 10, right around the 9-yard line. And they only get a yard back there. They'll be left with a third down and long. Throwing is Wilson. Michael Pierce, and with his 330-pound blitzery, gets the sack. And Charles, part of the reason they lost last week, they didn't have a single sack, but they changed that quickly.
But did they ever? And it was something they talked about with us extensively. They needed to get pressure. How were they going to get to the quarterback? Obviously, they schemed themselves into a great play, didn't they?
Now here's Michael Dixon. And no room for error here as his first punt comes from deep in his own end zone. And he's able to get it out of there. So just a 3-yard return following a punt of 45. And this offense takes over in great shape right at the 50, first and 10. And the Vikings taking the field here for their second drive of the game. They punted last time they had it. What steps, Charles, do you think they have to take to make sure they don't do that again?
Well, let's just go to the football 101, the trite expression 101. Win first down. Make 5, 6, 7 yards on first down and make it a 2nd and 3, 2nd and manageable. Keep accumulating first downs that way. Keep moving the football. You don't want to get behind the sticks because then the defense has the advantage. Usually we see runs like this as the defense breaks down later in the game, but this guy is setting the tone early, running through all types of tackles and putting the defense back on its heels.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a 1st and 10. On play action, Cousins. Airing it out deep for Smith. And at the 7-yard line, the catch is made. And he is out of bounds, but first he gets it inside the 10 to the 7. A gain of 32 that time.
We always talk about the guy who paid off the play, don't we? The guy who caught it or ran it. But how about the elements that go into making a big play? This one in particular, able to scan the field, Pocket held up nicely. What a terrific job by the offensive line. The route, well run, and the football, right on the money.
Now a chance to make that big play really hurt. It's first and goal just outside the five. They'll run with Cook. And running room scarce here. He's going to be stopped in his tracks at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play that time, and it sets up second and goal. They try again with Cook. And that'll move him a little closer as he takes it from the 7 down to the 4-yard line.
Yeah, baby.
Now we're going to get a timeout here as it looks like there's a Seahawk injured on the play. Well, he gets attended to. We'll step aside. A big play forthcoming. Here's third and goal.
Push it back. Push it back.
Cousins. And he's going to go down. Sacked back at the 13-yard line. Alden Smith, the former number 7 pick, gets the sack.
But it's about how teams are so competitively matched, and you just want to make those plays that give you an advantage. How about right here? The difference between letting them score a touchdown versus holding them to a field goal? That's absolutely huge with the play he just made.
And you know he hated taking the loss there on third down.
Austin Seibert on for the field goal. A 30-yard attempt.
Seibert's kick is good. And the Vikings have a 3-0 lead. They had it first and goal. 3 attempts, couldn't get it in, so they settle for 3.
Yeah, the field tends to shrink a little bit the closer you get to the goal line, doesn't it? It doesn't sound right. It sounds a little counterintuitive. But you run out of space to run the deep routes, so they can just sit on the shorter stuff if you're going to throw it. If you want to run it, there's just not as much space. They end up having to take 3 there.
Seattle's offense coming back onto the field, ready for their second drive. And the last drive, their first drive, 3 and out. What changes here, if anything?
I think it's making sure the guys that you trust the most with the ball, the biggest playmakers you have, that they touch it on this possession to try and get things moving.
So get it to the horses.
Without a doubt. They're the ones that typically end up in the end zone.
And this is dropped. Oh, boy. A chance for a big play early, but he could not secure it. Here's 2nd and 10. Wilson. That's into the hands of his tight end, Will Disley. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with 3rd and 1. Now Wilson. And unable to connect. If he had caught it, it would have been a 1st down. Instead, it's 4.
That looks like it's going to be 2 empty possessions now to start this football game. I think they're going to have to sit down and talk about what worked for them last week in their win. Sometimes you over-game plan, overthink things. Get back to what works.
Now here's Michael Dixon as he'll punt it away for the 2nd time. Call it 46 yards on the punt, just a single yard on the return as he was covered quickly. And the Vikings will take over here, 1st and 10. So here are the Vikings to take over. They lost 2 straight coming in, but good news for them right now. They've got the lead and the football. Cousins and the Vikings with a 1st and 10 at their own 27. Play fake. Cousins. It's caught. Smith. And he's brought down after a very nice game. Good work after the catch. Going to net him 23 and a first.
And Viking fans always remember that Kyle Rudolph held down the tight end position for the better part of a decade. But Irv Smith was drafted in the 2nd round in 2019 as his eventual replacement. And that time is now. A 1st down catch there for Smith.
They go play action. Cousins. Looking here for Smith downfield. And too much juice. It'll be out of bounds, incomplete. And now following the incomplete pass, we'll get a timeout here for an injured player. While the training staff takes a peek, we'll take a break.
Second and 10.
Cousins now from the 50. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on. Third down. On third down, Cousins.
He's going to get this one down to Cook.
Well, this is going to depend on the spot, but it's not a very generous one. He looks to be about a yard or so short.
A short game that doesn't get him the first down brings up a fourth down situation.
Really nice job defensively. They knew where the sticks were. They got the stop before it. Here's Britton Colquitt now as he'll kick it away for the second time. And now on fourth and one, it's a fake. And the gamble pays off. They get the first. A big pickup there, 20 yards as they convert on fourth. So they snap it straight to the up man. What's his responsibility? Normally, obviously, just to protect, but he's got to be a guy that can be pretty agile too, right?
Yeah, without a doubt, because you're talking about a guy, even in protection, he may have to slide up and down the line of scrimmage to pick up someone who comes through trying to block a punt. So you know he's got that ability to move. But oftentimes, it's a running back, a fullback, someone who's used to having the ball in their hands, and he's able to pick up the first down.
And they see right through that defensively as he'll be hit and taken down in the backfield. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
This defense is a difficult one to prepare for, one of the best in the league. They'll come at you from all angles, and they did a nice job there stopping him for a loss.
A rare misstep on that last play because the drive has been strong, but now it's second and 12. Handoff comes to Cook. And he's going to get this one down inside the 15.
51 yards rushing for him as he's got the afternoon off to a great start.
Third down, Dalvin Cook. And he will have the first down inside the 10 to the 9-yard line. Give him the third down conversion, 5 yards on the play. Now look, that wasn't a huge gain, but those are the types of carries I think they were missing in their loss last week. They couldn't get him going on the ground.
Did you get the same feeling I did during our meetings, that they kind of regretted that he didn't touch the
Absolutely.
Ball?
Absolutely.
You know, hey, he should have touched him more last week. They weren't going to make that same mistake, and they've taken care of that early.
They'll try and run for it on first and goal. He pushes forward for maybe 3 down to the 6-yard line.
Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
On second and goal, Cousins staying on his feet. But now he's swallowed up and taken down. Alton Robinson. Credit him with a sack as he buries him for a loss of 10.
Second goal, last thing you need to do is get pushed backwards to take a sack. But he couldn't find anywhere to go with the football. Had to eat it and ended up on the ground.
They've been denied touchdowns in the red zone twice already. Here comes third and goal. To throw is Cousins. Setting up the screen for Cook. And he'll get it here to the 10-yard line. They do get 7 out of that, but not enough to prevent a fourth down.
There certainly was a lot going on that play. Every option in the end zone covered. No place to go with the ball. Had to swing it out to the back. A good job running and getting him tackled in the open field.
Austin Seibert on for the field goal. A 27-yard attempt.
Seibert able to knock this one through. And that'll make it 6-0 here in the first. So a nice kick there as they're able to add on to their lead.
And that's exactly what you're looking yourself into range. That way, if your drive stalls out, you're able to get something out of it. And they do so right there.
This will be fielded inside the five. And he'll take it a yard or so past the 20. Call it the 21. Now going back over the Seattle Seahawks offense. They're still in search of an initial first down as they come up here first and 10. They'll start on the ground. It's Rashad Penny. Up past the 25 to the 26. A gain of 5. Now we're going to get a timeout here as it looks like there's a Seahawk injured on the play. While the trainers take a look, we'll step aside. The first down run got 5. Here's second and 5. Wilson leaves this one with Penny, and he powers his way up past the 30. After a gain of 5, they'll wind up being about a length of the football short here on third down. They'll try to run for it with Penny, and he's going to have the first down yardage to the 35. A third down gain of 3 yards, and that'll be enough.
They really needed to get something going, didn't they? They punted on the last two possessions. The running game starting to come to the front for them, providing a nice pickup there to keep this drive going.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Now it's Wilson. That's complete to Disley, the tight end. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down. The numbers for him from a week ago, 8 catches, 82 yards, and a touchdown.
When you turn in good, consistent performances each and every week, you will rank in the top 10 in the league in receiving yards, and he's number 7 currently, hoping to move up as time goes on. We think, Brandon, I like the intensity this defense is showing right here in these first few drives. They're not just holding the line because they're doing their job, but they're doing more than that, aren't they? They're getting a nice push into the offensive backfield.
And a great example right there for the loss on the tackle. On third down, Penny. And he's going to be taken down here, still a couple yards short of the first. Give him 2 yards on the gain there, and it will take us to the end of quarter number 1. Nothing, our score after 1. Seahawk football here to start quarter number 2. Now here's Michael Dixon as he's on to punt for Seattle. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. And a great job on special teams to down it as this will be marked out inside the 5-yard line.
That punt was near perfection as it checked up inside the 5-yard line. You never know where these things are going to go, do you?
No, what was it? You got a John Heisman quote about that,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, he said the football is roughly a prolate spheroid, which means it's going to bounce funny, and you never know where it's going to end up.
The Minnesota offense about ready to get this next drive underway. And they will start this drive with just terrible field position, backed up inside their own 5.
But we have seen teams be bold here and take shots, right? Sometimes you go max protection, make it a 1-receiver route, and take your shot downfield and see what happens. And occasionally, we've seen success occur.
And he will take this up to about the 8-yard line. A 1-yard gain there following the 3-yard pickup on first down. Complete. It's Johnson. And he will have a Vikings first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. They get 6 on the pickup there as the drive continues.
And that's one of those where it feels like backyard football in a sense. You say forget about the route. Just run to the open spot in the middle of the field and I'll find you. Good throw, good concentration on the catch, and they pick up the first down.
Here's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line. Another tote for the workhorse this afternoon. It's Cook, and he's going to have just a couple here with a marker on the field as well. So this will be accepted as it moves the offense backwards. To throw, Cousins. He gets this one into the hands of Dalvin Cook. Now Cook hit and he lost the football. And the Seahawks have picked it up. And they bring this one back. It's a fumble recovery and a Seattle touchdown. So the big fella gets on the scoreboard with a return for a touchdown. Good thing he didn't have to go too far, though.
You know the trainers were very happy about that. Imagine having to go get him in the end zone, escort him to the bench, and give him the oxygen. They were loving the fact that he got in without having to run very far.
Jason Myers now for the extra point. He's got it, and they take the lead at 7-6. So not only the cough up, but then the pickup on the other side, the scoop, and the score the other way, the fumble return for a touchdown. So here's the kickoff now as he'll get it again following that fumble return for a score. And he'll just sit on this one as their drive will start at the 25. Dalvin Cook taking the field for the Vikings' next possession. Looking for a bounce back. Had the fumble a moment ago that went for a touchdown the other direction. See if he can get back in rhythm.
And you have to be very careful about having too quick of a hook with really good players. I did a guy's game in high school where he fumbled 3 times in the first quarter.
And he loses the football a second time. And the Seahawks have picked it up. And they bring this one back. It's a fumble recovery and a Seattle touchdown. Fumbles, that's how you get in the coach's doghouse. The first one lost and it hurt. This time you lose it and it's taken in for a score. It really hurt.
And about that doghouse, it won't exactly be comfortable and it definitely won't be air conditioned.
Milk bones?
None.
Now Myers for the extra point. And it's up. It's good. Our score, 14-6. The scoop and score, always an exciting play in football, and we witnessed it there, grabbing it off the ground and then rumbling it into the end zone for 6. Oh, good return up past the 30. And I got to be pleased with this. He brings it all the way up to the 40-yard line.
And that's the kind of return you're looking for. To get to that spot on the field, that allows you to do a lot of things on offense.
And out now come the Vikings.
And in just about every game we see, partner, what do? When we look at the stat sheet, we go right to
the turnover differential.
Without a doubt, because when we see that, that pretty much tells the tale of the game. And I know there's still plenty of time to go, but you've got to take care of the football in order to win it.
This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, 2nd and 2. Here's Madison getting it again on 2nd. And he'll take it down shy of the 45 at the 46.
First and 10 at the 46-yard line.
First down, here's the run with Cook. He takes it down to the 42, a 5-yard run. 2nd down and 5.
He's brought down at the 42-yard line.
From the pistol, they run it with Cook. And the lane closes up quickly as he'll get about 3 down to the 38. The Vikings on 3rd down, 3 for 7 so far in this game. Here it's 3rd and 2. And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36.
Well, partner, what do you think? Might have been 4-down territory if they didn't pick it up, but...
Yeah, it's a moot point now. I was curious, though, if they didn't get it there, would they have gone for it? I guess we'll never know.
Yeah, we didn't have to make that call, but I have a feeling both of us would have said, go for it.
All run
runs on this drive so far. It's first and 10. Running from the shotgun with Madison. They give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and 6.
He's brought down at the 31. A gain of 4. It's now second and 6.
On the handoff, it's Madison. It'll only be a gain of 1 yard, and it sets up a 3rd down and 4 now.
Now that's a mountain of a man that just made that stop, isn't it? But he's more than that. This guy is nimble and quick, more than a space eater. He just made a great play there.
A 3rd field goal of the first half, not what they're looking for as they come up on 3rd down. Now Cousins. This time for Smith, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Jamal Adams. And Charles, that's now 4 interceptions over his last 3 halves of football, because remember, he threw 3 picks last week.
Starting to wonder if maybe defenses and those coordinators have identified something on tape with what he's doing. Maybe a movement, maybe the way he's moving his shoulders. Who knows what it could be? He could have a few tells out there that they're keying in on and allowing defenses to get to the football a little bit faster. People steal signals. Maybe sometimes they can figure out what the quarterback's doing just by his movements.
After the interception, here's Wilson. Short throw to Disley. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line.
Here we go. Here we go.
The catch and run, good for 18 and a 1st down.
So many times in my career, I've heard coaches talk about completions are one thing, but as long as we're there at the catch and we get guys on the ground, we can live with that. But if you're going to give up 10, 12, 15 yards after the catch, then your defense is going to be in a lot of trouble.
From the 32 now, here's 1st and 10. They'll run with Penny here out of the shotgun. And he'll work this one up to about the 38. A solid run on 1st down, gain of 7, leaves him with a 2nd and 3.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on 1st down, that fits the bill.
So they'll come up after the gain of 7 on a 2nd and 3. From the gun, a give to Penny. And this will be a Seahawks 1st down as good running gets him to about the 44.
It's a gain of 6. 1st down, Seattle.
Wilson now off the bootleg. Steps away to his left. And smartly going into the slide there, Wilson has enough for the first.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there, not there. After about the 3rd one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
From Viking territory now, they'll come up 1st and 10 at the 35-yard line. Wilson. And that one drops down, incomplete. Good coverage there, forced the ball free, and it's 2nd down. To throw again on 2nd down, Wilson. And he's just going to get rid of this thing to no one here. He throws it away, and now it's 3rd. On 3rd down, Wilson. Pressure comes, and Wilson's going to go down. Danielle Hunter picks up his 2nd sack of the afternoon. So, Charles, no turnovers yet for this offense, but those sacks now, they're starting to pile up.
And one thing usually leads to another, because they've got to figure out how the offensive line and everyone else involved in protection can keep their quarterback upright and allow him a chance to throw the ball downfield.
Now here's Michael Dixon. He's been terrific so far. Gets it away, and I don't think Peterson will get a chance to touch this one. Angling for the sideline. Now
Now the Vikings offense gets set to take over here. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack him here. 80 yards rushing for him, as he has been tough to stop here this first half. Play action now, Cousins. Open man here is Conklin. First target, first catch, and a first down. A give, this is Cook. And this will be a Vikings first down as the tackle made it about the 43-yard line. He continues to be effective running the football, a big reason that they have the lead.
And I love one of the quotes that I read about him where he said of himself, "I love it when a team just hops on my back and I just carry them along."
A first down throw for Cousins. And he'll find Thielen on the right side. Second down and three.
Brings up second and three at the 50-yard line.
Cousins gives way to Cook. And he'll be brought down at the 45-yard line. A gain of five, good enough for the first down.
First and 10 at the 45.
On the ground, it's Cook. And he's able to get this one down to about the 40. Give him five on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
A gain of five brings up second and five.
Now a give to Madison. And they'll be inside the 35 now at the 34-yard line. 6 yards to pick up, and that's a first down.
First and 10 at the 34.
Cook. And a short gain down to about the 33. Cody Barton there to bring him down. The run only got a yard. Here's second and nine. They'll try to throw now. Cousins. That's to Cook out of the backfield. Now after the completion, we're going to get a timeout. An injured player. We'll check on his status when we get back. A third field goal of the first half, not what they're looking for as they come up on third down. Throwing, Cousins. Toward the sideline, did he keep the feet in? Yes, he got them both down, says the side judge, and that's good enough for a first down. His first catch, and it's a pretty big one. They get the conversion on third down. He's such a good route runner. Shows it there on third down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times, because he can trust you being in the right spot, and they connected there and picked up a first down.
Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10. Here's Cousins. And that is incomplete. Oh, the coverage a little too good there, and it's second down. They were looking for Johnson that time. Cousins again, and that'll bring up second down. And he's going to go down. Back at the 27-yard line, he's sacked. Jordan Brooks, what a play by him. That's going to go as a loss of 13. These sacks now, they're starting to pile up, Charles, and that front seven defensively, they've had their way with this offensive line.
And I think at this stage, we have to start thinking about different play calls. We've got to start helping this quarterback out, because the entire game he's been under siege. I don't care what the down and distance, they've got to get the ball out of his hands a lot quicker.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And quickly to Thielen here. Now the Seahawks going to use the first of their timeouts, as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next.
A 33-yard attempt.
Seibert's kick is good. And that'll get the lead down to 5. So the 3 points there in CD, that helps him inch a bit closer.
Yeah, Barney, when you're losing, any points you see go on the board in your favor, you're happy to take them.
Minnesota's kick team ready, and the Vikings boom it away. Taking in at the 3. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line.
The Seahawks take over first and 10 at their own.
DK Metcalf of the Seattle offense about set to take over once again. Not only does he not have a catch, I don't think he's been targeted in this game, but they're winning.
And if you ask a receiver of his magnitude, he'll tell you that it's because everyone is focused on him anyway. Okay, you've taken it away. No catches, no targets, but we're still winning. I've opened things up for the rest of my team. I know how receivers think.
They've been using him as a decoy, and effectively so. Now the Seahawks call the second of their 3 timeouts as they'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime. A good gain on first has him set up with second and just a couple of inches now from the 29. Throwing is Wilson. Leaves it for Petty. And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. 4 yards the pickup, first down. Now Wilson. They'll get this out wide to Penny. They'll contain him to just 4. Second down. Now the Seahawks forced to use their 3rd and final timeout as the clock will stop with 21 seconds to go here in the first half. To throw again is Wilson. Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done. And give him 17 yards that time as that'll move the chains.
He's certainly done a nice job spreading the field on this drive, and here he finds his big tight end for good yardage. And that's what you have to do. Keep defenses guessing about where you're going to go with the football.
Jason Meyer is on the field. A 58-yard attempt.
And I tell you what, he got it from 58. That had lots of leg behind it. So a nice kick there as they add 3 to the lead.
And from what I've seen so far, Brandon, I think they've been the better of the 2 teams here in the first half. So even though you want the touchdown, I think that's a nice job there to put 3 points on the board.
This will be fielded inside the 5. And able to get this out to the 25.
Let's go, let's go.
Flag coming out as they line up to kneel on it.
Hey, Flipper.
And with time running short here, they'll simply take a knee, and that should do it for half number 1. So we've come upon halftime with the visiting Seahawks. They're out in front as we send you down to Orlando where Jonathan Coachman has our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
All right, Brandon, thanks. And welcome in everybody to our EA Sports Halftime Report. Time for a look around the NFL here in week 3 of the new year. We begin with a good one out in Southern California. Tampa Bay taking on the LA Rams. And it's the Rams who have the lead in the second quarter. The Rams trying to hold on and claim victory. Next, we'll check in on the silver and black as we head to Las Vegas to see what's happening with the Raiders. And right now, they have the lead over the visiting Dolphins. Derek Carr has a couple of touchdown passes there. Lastly, let's get out to Jacksonville, see what's happening with the Jaguars at TIAA Bank Field. And they were winners in that one over the visiting Arizona Cardinals. Trevor Lawrence, 2 touchdown passes as his guys remain unbeaten. Continuing on, here's a look at the next-gen stats in that first half. And even though they've got the lead, they're likely going over ways they can improve the running game, as they didn't find a whole lot of success in those first 2 quarters. Meanwhile, for the Vikings, it's been no contest in terms of the rushing yards. You see a much, much brighter picture there.
Okay, Coach, appreciate it. A 1-touchdown game here as we get set to resume play in the second half. Taking it about the 1. And he won't get this to the 20-yard line as he's down at the 19. The Seahawk offense set to go to begin this third quarter. And they've got the lead. CD, what do you think the message was at halftime?
I don't think the message was too drastic, I think, at the half, or that they need to change things too much. I do think the offensive line could play a little bit better. I think they'll try and help them out more. They'll probably keep a tight end in a few more times and maybe add a running back to the formation to pick up those pass rushers, because they probably allowed a few too many sacks for comfort in the first half. Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs, as we just saw.
Looking for Lockett, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Harrison Smith, and he's going to get this one to the 23-yard line. That is just what this defense was hoping for, an interception on the opening possession of this third quarter.
Obviously didn't want to surrender a touchdown and fall even farther behind, and we've gotten to know this team a little bit, haven't we? Couldn't you just see their defensive leaders telling the offensive guys, telling the quarterback, don't worry, we got you to start things off. You take it from there.
It's the Vikings' turn on offense. We get ready for their first possession of the second half. They just got a little help from their defense, forcing the turnover. Now can they make that payoff in points?
They need to, partner. They're down on the scoreboard. Need to take advantage of those opportunities, and this is a good one right in front of them.
A run on first down, but it's not going to get them much. Maybe a yard, and that's all.
He was brought down by Olmstead. A gain of a yard. Brings up second and nine at the 22-yard line.
On second and nine, Cousins to the right side and complete to Jefferson. And he'll go out of bounds in the red zone just inside the 20.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
They had great starting position to begin the drive, but now they look up at a third and five. Cousins to throw it. And this is going to be caught. No, they say it's incomplete. Just what Seattle was hoping for. The coverage holds, and now fourth down. Seibert able to knock this one through, and that'll get the lead down to five. They got the interception, but very little movement after. That forces him to settle for three, and it does feel like settling when that happens, doesn't it?
It certainly does, but we got to give a lot of credit where it's due, and that's to the defense because they ran onto the field. This is what we call sudden change, right? Interception, you've got to go put out the fire, and they did, holding them to a field goal.
Russell Wilson now gears up to lead the offense again. And he comes out on the heels of an interception he threw last time they had the ball.
Yeah, and you know, the quarterbacks that I know that are the best ones, the ones that really know how to lead their team, they tell them, that's on me. That's my bad. But let's go back out there and move ahead again, guys. We can get this done.
One good thing for him, it did only lead to 3 points and not a touchdown after that turnover.
Big thanks to the defense.
Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine. Now, they struggled to get him rolling on the ground in the first half, and that's sort of continuing here in the third quarter.
Yeah, but I don't think it's time to abandon the running game. I would say keep feeding the horse, and I believe he'll eventually reward them, especially as we get deeper in the game.
Now they'll run it again with Penny. Nowhere to go that time. Might have gotten a yard up to the 25. From the gun on third down, Wilson. This complete to Lockett. And he will be marked down short of the first as they get to him at the 29.
One hallmark of good defenses is understanding the game, understanding positioning, and tackling immediately in the secondary after catches. I think we just saw that on display right there.
Got to him before he ever had a chance to think about turning it upfield. Now here's Michael Dixon as he's on for the fifth time here today. And he deserves a bronze leg as he gets this one away. So a change of possession here on the punt. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. Now the Vikings offense works their way back onto the field. And after the field goal last time, we'll see what they can get here. And at least they got points out of the last drive, Charles.
I never met an offensive coach that didn't want a drive to end with a kick. Most of them want to end with a PAT, right? In this case, a field goal, they'll take it. Way better than the alternative, which is a punt.
Yeah, but you met fan bases that wanted that, that weren't happy with that field goal.
I haven't met a fan base yet that wants a drive to end with a kick, other than the extra point. That's it.
On second down, this is Madison. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. They'll get three as the drive continues. It's a first down.
First and 10 at the 34-yard line.
Here's Madison. And he'll get two, maybe three, up near the 37.
Yeah, I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up, found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense. The playbook is still open for the coordinator.
The last run got three. Now here's second and seven. From the shotgun, it's Cousins. And the pressure too much that time as Cousins goes down. Alden Smith able to get in there for his second sack of the afternoon. And keep in mind, in addition to the two sacks that he now has, CD, he's also had a couple of quarterback hurries. He's been very disruptive.
To put it mildly, and it reminds me of the time I asked an offensive tackle who struggled like this in a game. He said he was telling the coach, hey, what do you want me to do? This guy's just eating me alive. And the coach finally just looked at him and said, applaud.
So now after the sack, Cousins and the Vikings come up here third and long. Throwing his Cousins. He gets this one to Johnson. And he'll be brought down at the 34, well short of the first down marker. Now we'll look at Smith. Not sure exactly what happened, but he's still down. While the training staff works on him, we'll step aside and be right back. Here's Britton Colquitt now, as he's on to punt for Minnesota. It'll be a net of 40 yards there following a 43-yard punt, 3-yard return, and it'll be Seahawk football first and 10. So here are the Seahawks ready to take over on offense. They've won two straight, and they lead this one as well as they come up on first and 10. Now it's Wilson. That's complete to DK Metcalf. Shoves him aside. Touchdown, Seahawks! DK Metcalf, 77 yards. And the Seahawks are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. For DK Metcalf, we know all about that sprinter speed that he has. It was definitely on display there as he's able to pick up good yardage after the catch. Extra point up and through by Myers. And it gives his guys a 12-point advantage. Well, the offense wasn't out there for a long time, but they were out there for a good time. One play, and they're able to hit pay dirt. The kick unit for the Seahawks out there on the field, and we are ready to rock. The return man down to a knee, and this will come out to the 25-yard line. Now the Minnesota offense set to take over again and hoping to do better than they did their last possession when they punted the football.
Appeal to the vanity of your offensive line. Tell them that they control your fate. Leverage guys. Win the line of scrimmage. If you do that, you start to win first down. You win second down. And guess what? You start accumulating first downs. And that's what they need in order to not punt the ball again.
They start the drive with Cook. And he's upended after a gain of two out to the 27. The last run good for two. Here's second and eight. Cousins now. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Osborne.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. But slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
And Cook was fighting for it, but I don't think he got there. No gain on the play there. A nice job defensively, and it likely forces a punt situation on Ford.
They've called his number a lot this afternoon. You wonder how much tread is left on those tires.
We certainly do, but I always think back to one of my favorite coaches in the NFL, and he used to have a meeting with his running backs every year in the offseason and say, look, as many times as you're going to carry the ball, you should be able to carry it one more time, so make sure you get in shape.
Here's Britton Colquitt now, as he's on to punt for Minnesota. It's a 39-yard punt, 3 on the return, and the offense will take over with a new set of downs. The Seattle offense now set to come back out on the field. And last time, the formula was pretty simple. One play drive, long pass. That maybe they just want to do that again, right?
And that's exactly how you want to draw things up, whether it's on your grease board, right, in your playbook, one play.
Pressure comes, and Wilson's going to go down. Danielle Hunter able to disrupt yet another pass play. That is his third sack of the afternoon.
It seemed like he kept going through those progressions, and I thought he might dump that underneath, but he couldn't get rid of the football in time.
And I have to wonder if he was thinking while he was back there, I wish there were a lot less progressions on this play, just someone that I could dump the ball to and get it out of my hands.
So that complicates things a bit here. 18 yards to go now on second down. Another try after the first down sack. Wilson, that's complete to Disley, the tight end. And he's going to get 7 out of this before being taken down at the 27. The reception good for 7. It's third down. That's a staple of this offense. Drag route to the tight end.
Yeah, he's unable to use his size to break off much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective gain nonetheless.
Now Wilson. And he'll just toss it away. So he throws it away, and that brings up fourth down.
Yeah, that's a nice job there defensively to blanket those receivers on third down. And as a quarterback, all you can do is just loft one toward the bench, not too close, mind you, and live to punt the football.
Now a hit and a loose football. And the Seahawks have picked it up. And his guys are going to get the football at the 23-yard line.
I don't know why, but it's always agonizing to me to see a guy make a mistake in this phase of the game because you can it's all on him. All eyes there. He's got a chance to make a punt return, and instead, he ends up putting it on the carpet.
Puts it on the carpet. The little rubber pellets shoot up. And now before the ball changes hands, they're going to take a look at this just to make sure that they have it right. Now the question, was the knee in fact down before this ball comes loose? And is the video convincing enough to overturn it?
A lot of factors here. Remember, you also need clear possession of the football afterwards. This is a tough one to overturn.
So that one overturned. They say the knee was down, and that will not be ruled a fumble. Give him 9 there on the first down completion. On second down, Cook. And just shedding him off there. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Now a look at Smith. Not sure exactly what happened, but he's still down. Well, he gets attended to. We'll step aside. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Now Cook. Give him 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7. Coming right, this is Cook on the toss play. A nice little juke.
And they're well past midfield, just a yard or two shy of the 40. 132 yards for him on the ground now as he has been terrific here this afternoon.
I think they like this drive a little bit better there, partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember the last drive, they went three and out.
So from Seahawk territory now, it's first and 10 at the 41. Handoff comes to Cook, and maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
Well, that was one of the few times they've been able to contain him thus far. He's over 100 yards for the game, but he lost a bit off his total on that carry.
Now they contend with a second and 12 after the loss. To throw, Cousins. And that is incomplete here. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Cousins. And the catch made by Johnson. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. They get 14 there. First down, Vikings. Back to the ground, Cook. And he'll take this down just shy of the 25-yard line. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Well, that's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play? It was only a 3-yard run, but for both sides, they had to walk away from that feeling like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
Another good completion on the drive as the Vikings have a first down.
And I'll tell you what, this offense is playing a little bit of keep away right now. They've come out here in the third quarter, possessed the ball for quite a while, and they keep on converting. Nice pitch and catch there to set up the first and goal.
First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. They'll run with Cook. And the hole closes quickly here. He can fight only to about the 4. Give him 3 on the gain there. Second and goal.
Brings up second and goal at the Seahawks.
Now Cousins. And a big loss here as he's taken down. Now whistles and a timeout. Looks like we've got a Viking slow to get up. While the training staff takes a peek, we'll take a break. Way back at the 19 now. What do they have here on third and goal? Working out of the gun, Cousins. Throw left side, complete. That's Johnson. Give him 13 yards on the connection, but not enough. Fourth down.
That's certainly playing down in distance very well by the defense, isn't it? Take whatever you want underneath, by all means.
Austin Seibert on for the field goal. A 23-yard attempt.
Seibert's kick is good. And that lead is back down to 9 now. So yet another field goal to end the drive. That has been a very common theme. He's now hit 5 of them in this game.
Yeah, Brandon, as an offense, you hate that you've had to call on your kicker so often, but you have to love the fact that time and time again, he's come through.
And taken down just past the 20 at about the 21-yard line. The Seahawks again now ready to take over on offense. And they're coming off a 3-and-out, my friend.
I think they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you've called before, realize it hasn't worked.
Go to something else.
And maybe try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
Play action. Now Wilson. Going for Metcalf on the deep ball. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete. The intended receiver was DK Metcalf, and it's third and short. They'll try to run for it with Penny. And that one going
nowhere from the start as he's met in the backfield and goes backwards. Defensively, they rally the troops to force fourth down after that 7-yard pickup back on first.
I'll tell you what, this defense hasn't played its best, but they're still right in this football game. And if they keep making plays just like that, they're going to give their offense a chance.
Now here's Michael Dixon as he's on to punt for Seattle. It's a 45-yard punt, just a 1-yard return. And out will come the offense as they take over. Minnesota's offense takes over possession. Their drive last time, it stalled out. They were forced to take the short field goal.
And the key phrase, you nailed it, forced to, because you know coaches look at these short field goals as a last resort, right? To them, that's not how drives are supposed to end. You're supposed to put 6 on the board. That's a consolation prize, like going to the county fair. You don't get the big stuffed animal on that one, do you?
No, you don't go top shelf. That's bottom shelf material. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down.
25-yard line.
56.
From the gun, here's Cousins. Oh, and that'll be incomplete. Well, he took a shot as he let that go. And it's going to bring up a third down. On third down, Cousins. Got an open man finding Jefferson. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. And they convert on third with a gain of 22.
And that's how you pick up a first down. Not only does he make the catch, but has enough body control to get his feet down in bounds, toe-tapping and dragging to make sure he gets it done.
First down, here's Cousins. Oh, he's going to let this go for the end zone. And Thielen's got it. Touchdown, Vikings. Adam Thielen. His first touchdown of the new season. And the Vikings are able to get a score back in the final stages of this third quarter. Extra point by Seibert, up and good. And now things get a bit more interesting here in this fourth quarter. And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. And we return welcoming you back to Minneapolis, where the fourth quarter will begin with a kickoff following the score on the final play of the third quarter. And this will be a touchback, so they'll bring it out to the 25. Here's Russell Wilson and the Seahawk offense now getting set to go again. And after the slow start, the numbers show he has really straightened things out. How often sometimes is that you come into a game and the defense is game planned a little differently than you expected?
More often than maybe people realize, so adjustments are often a big part of each and every game, and it's not just getting to halftime. It's series to series to make it work, and being able to hang in there when there's a little adversity early and see them able to flip it around, it's kind of gratifying for a team to watch, especially for a coach.
And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. That catch puts him over 70 yards receiving now as he's got a first down. To throw is Wilson. And the throw left sideline here is caught, but they'll rule it incomplete. Couldn't keep his feet in. Second down. To throw on second and 10. Wilson. Short throw to Disley. 5 yards. Now it's third and 5. Throwing again here, Wilson. They'll lock it with a grab over the middle. And he is going to have a Seahawks first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. The third down conversion is successful. Give him 12 yards that time. A bit of a catch for him to remember. That's number 400 for his NFL career. Not a bad number at all. We saw a number of good games earlier today. This one might top all of those. It's been a dandy as we come up on first and 10. Wilson leaves this one with Penny. And he works it past the 30, almost to the 25. 43 yards rushing on 12 carries for him now.
Well, it is our business to analyze what we saw out there. And on that play, I saw a defense staying in base, not taking a chance, not blitzing in a situation when they absolutely need the football back. That's either a case of overthinking it or not thinking it through.
If you do blitz, do you have to be careful about where you're coming from, or are you just coming from all angles?
You have to be careful about where you're coming from, obviously, but at this stage, you have to take a few chances as well.
Working the middle here, that's complete to Everett, the tight end. And they'll work it inside the 15-yard line before it's all said and done. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down.
And these guys certainly are not hiding what their intention is. They're absolutely showing it. They're definitely not going to sit on this lead here in the fourth quarter.
From the red zone now, here's Wilson on first down. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And he's able to work it here to the 8-yard line. 6 yards on the pickup, and it's a second down. Wilson. And he is going to go down. Back at the 11-yard line. They've been moving the ball well offensively, really getting into a groove. Last play, pass completion. Now, finally, the defense gets there.
And you have to find a way to disrupt their rhythm. Do you do it with coverage, or do you do it with pressure? They elected to go with pressure, and it was the right call.
Out of the huddle now for play number 9 on this drive. This is third down and 8. Out of the gun, here's Wilson. And a quick throw here, that's complete. Touchdown!
Oh, yeah.
Gerald Everett, his second touchdown on the season. And the Seahawks add on to their lead.
So a heck of a drive right there with the game potentially hanging in the balance.
A very good drive, and now a conversion to make it a 2-score game and a solid lead.
The extra point now coming from Myers. And that makes it a 9-point game. So that one, a pretty time-consuming 10-play drive. And it all culminates with a Seattle score. The kick unit for the Seahawks out there on the field, and we are ready to rock.
Taking it about the 1. And makes it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line.
And now out comes Minnesota.
And you figure after giving up that last touchdown, you know, they trail by 2 scores here in the fourth quarter. This drive becomes very critical.
Cousins and the Vikings with a 1st and 10 at their own 23.
Right there, 54, right there, right there.
Throwing, Cousins. Now the pressure comes and he goes down. Just inside the 10, back at the 9. The sack there by Rasheem Green.
So if we recount real quick, he had the touchdown earlier, and now he comes up with the sack here. No doubt about it, he's having himself a game.
So after the sack, a scenario you certainly don't work on too often. 2nd and 24. Another try after the first down sack. Cousins
swinging this out wide here for Cook.
And they're able to bring him down at the 20. It's a pickup of 12, and that'll set up a 3rd down. Here's Cousins. And that's going to be incomplete. The coverage too good there. The contact popped the ball free, and it's 4th down. Colquitt on to kick as he sends it away. Yeah, call it 38 yards on the punt, no return. The Seahawks offense now, they get set to go back to work. Well, there are 2 scores on the plus side. Still time here in this fourth quarter, but maybe you start thinking about playing keep away?
Yeah, I think here's the situation. You're not thinking touchdowns anymore. You're just thinking first downs. To keep up with your theme there, playing keep away, first downs, they can't touch the ball.
Pressure comes and Wilson's going to go down. Danielle Hunter able to record
his fifth sack of the season. I don't know what else can be said about this pass rush. They have been sensational. CD, that is now six sacks for them.
And how many times do we talk to offensive coordinators and they say a sack is a result of everyone on offense not doing their job? But let's be honest about this one. This is the offensive line unable to counter the pass rush. They've been teeing off all game long.
And they need to work to at least get some of this yardage back after the sack. Second and 19. Now a nice throw here, right side. He hauls it in. And he's brought down after a very nice gain. A gain there of 21 yards.
Partner, I like that they're staying aggressive on offense because to me, this drive is what is known as a put-away drive. You score here, that might put this one to bed. I like the fact that they're playing with confidence and not playing with fear.
They go play action with Wilson. He lets it fly for Lockett. And this is incomplete. Oh, it looked like he had a pretty good line on that one. That would have been a big play, but he could not pull it in. From midfield now, here's Wilson. He's going to go up top again. And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete. Dwayne Eskridge, the intended receiver. That takes us from second to third down. An important play right here, third and 10.
And I would expect pressure here.
Wilson will throw again. He'll find his man. That's Freddie Swain. And past the 35, he'll be dropped a yard or two shy of the 30. His first catch, and it's a pretty big one. They get the conversion on third down.
Well, normally you might say start running the football. You've got the lead here in the fourth quarter, but the way that they've passed it with such success, I don't know, maybe keep throwing it.
Yeah, I think you brought up something that goes against conventional wisdom, right? In this stage of the game, you would think you would switch to a running attack, but you're exactly right. They've thrown it so well throughout the game, and trusting this quarterback, I think he continued to do so.
Well, throw on first down with Wilson. And intercepted, maybe the turning point they need. Picked off by the linebacker, Eric Kendricks. Score game here in the fourth, and that pick, it kind of keeps the door ajar, doesn't it?
It does, and you wonder about their strategy because with a two-score lead, you would think maybe you're just sitting on it trying to drain some clock. It's almost like they felt like, hey, we've got a good cushion. We can keep pressing it. It ended up costing them.
Following the interception, Cousins lets it fly for Thielen. And that's going to wind up incomplete. However, we do have a flag down. Let's check in with our referee. This home crowd, they're happy with that call.
I like the way you said happy there, right? The so-called good guys didn't get a call. They feel like it's been that way all afternoon. You feeling their pain?
They finally got one.
Yes, they did.
Toward the back corner of the end zone, but he could not get the feet down. This will wind up incomplete. He was looking for Adam Thielen there. And it's second down. Mike Zimmer staring down our referee. He's upset. He's going to throw out the red challenge flag. They're taking a peek at whether or not those feet were in bounds, and obviously a big call here in the end zone.
And not just the feet. How about the hands? How is the ball possessed while the feet are hopefully getting down in bounds? That's what they're trying to look at to see if it all comes together.
So that challenge, not successful there. That's going to cost him the first of his timeouts. And that'll fall incomplete. He was hit just as he let that go. And now it's third down.
We've seen this quite a few times in this game. Offensive line unable to keep leverage, unable to keep people away, facing a lot of pressure. Fortunate just to get rid of it.
One of the reasons they're down is that inability, though, to stop the pressure. We saw another example of it there.
Right there.
To throw is Cousins. He'll let this go for the end zone. Toward the back corner of the end zone, but he could not get the feet down. This will wind up incomplete.
A 55-yard attempt.
And that is no good. He gave it a good run. That wasn't more than a foot or so wide to the left. And this score will stay right where it is. And that one, just an absolute killer. A chance to get this back within one score.
All hope not gone yet. But at the same time, you're exactly right. They needed to get back within one score and have a motivated defense take the field in order to get it back for them for one last big drive.
Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And even with the missed field goal that we just saw, they still have to try and erase a two-score fourth quarter deficit.
And taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40.
They may want to go back to that one. First play of the drive, good for 15 and a first down.
Now, I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage, work on that clock, see if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely. You want to bleed things out at this point, right? Continue to possess the football, gain some yardage, and put the onus on the defense. Do they have to use timeouts? What are they going to do to stop you? You're taking charge.
Now Rashad Penny. Able to push forward for about four down to the 37. Following the pickup of four, here's second and six. The toss running left. This is Penny. And he's going to be stopped just short of the first down marker at the Vikings 32. On third and one, Wilson. It's caught. Block it. And he's got this down almost to the 20 before he's dropped. Now after the completion, we're going to get a timeout, an injured player. While the trainers take a look, we'll step aside. On first and 10, it's Wilson. Returning right back to Lockett. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right in a yard. Give him 9 there on the first down completion. They go back to the ground now with Penny. And he's able to work it here to the 8-yard line. They'll try and run for it with Penny. And he is in for the Seattle touchdown. Rashad Penny, an 8-yard touchdown run. And the Seahawks are closing in on a third straight victory to start the campaign. A 15-point game now. You make the extra point, and that means on the other side you need 2 touchdowns and 2 two-point conversions. That's a pretty tall order here in the fourth quarter.
Agreed, because they really needed to come up with a stop there, and even if it was just to hold them to a field goal. Now they need to pull out the lucky horseshoe because they've got to get an onside kick. And we've seen nowadays, those are incredibly difficult to come by.
And not to mention, they got to get the touchdown and a two-point conversion first. So they elect to pass there on the two-point try. Sometimes could prove risky. There it worked out.
Yeah, and I love how you bring up that it can prove risky, because if you get it intercepted and they return it, that's 2 points for the defense, but not on that play.
The kick unit for the Seahawks out there on the field, and we are ready to rock. Taking it about the 1. And good coverage there on special teams as he'll get him down shy of the 20. Minnesota now ready for their next possession. And they unfortunately are staring at a mini losing streak developing, trailing here in the fourth quarter. This would be their third straight defeat.
Cousins and the Vikings with a first and 10 at their own 19-yard line.
Now Cousins. Johnson's got it complete. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. Nice way to start the drive, a gain of 12 and a first down.
Well, I can put my defensive cap on right now, and I know they're saying don't give up any big plays now. They've controlled this game throughout, and all they want to do is see it through to the end. I think they let their guard down a little bit with that last completion. Sometimes when you're trying not to give up bigger plays, you don't react as fast as you should on other throws.
Now a throw here to his running back, and he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. They get 14 there. First down, Vikings.
First and 10.
Cousins. He'll find Thielen work in the middle. Now he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. That good for 21 yards on the catch and run.
And it shouldn't come as any surprise that you say Adam Thielen made a catch, and it was for a first down. He comes off another solid season, over 900 yards receiving, one of the best route runners in the NFL.
So from Seahawk territory now, it's first and 10, down at the 33.
Mine's 54.
They'll throw again, Cousins. That's to Cook out of the backfield. And he is out of bounds inside the 30.
Out of bounds at the 26-yard line. A 7-yard pickup.
Looking to throw again on second down. Cousins, he's going to let it go deep for the end zone. And oh, that one going to wind up incomplete. Nearly an interception in the end zone. Probably should have been. Third down coming up. So the incomplete pass on the last play, and that leads us to a 3rd and 3. Cousins. Gonna throw deep for the end zone. And this is caught. Touchdown. Wait, hold a second here. Flag down. Let's see if this will stand. Down in this one, they needed that score, but they'll have to hold at least for the time being.
You're exactly right. Points that they had to have. As you said, they have to regroup now and see if they can get them another way.
All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it. Running for it. Here's Cook. And boy, is he close. Did he get there? No, they're going to say he's short of the line to gain. Dalvin Cook turned away on fourth down. And the Seahawks are going to take over the football. Well, they knew who to turn to on fourth down, their horse. They needed the short yardage. He just couldn't get it.
And that's a surprise because normally that's bread and butter for them, right? Hand it to the big guy, let him go, pick up the first down. Didn't get it there. All credit to the defense. Usually, even if they know he's coming, he can't be stopped, and they got it done on that play.
So it's Seahawk football as we march toward a conclusion. And you'd have to figure they're just looking to burn these final 2 minutes away and get out of here with a victory. A pickup of about 3 yards as he's taken down at the 31. 3 yards on the pickup. That's going to set up an interesting third and about 4 to go. There's Wilson to throw. Open man is Metcalf. He's got it. And he is going to have a Seahawks first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. And with that last play, he's now up over that 300-yard mark.
And in today's NFL, it almost feels routine. And I hate that when you talk about a 300-yard passing game. To me, 300 yards still signifies excellence, and he's achieved that in this performance.
Penny, a first down carry. Oh, but a great tackle there. Going to hold him to no gain as the clock runs. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down. So the victory here for Seattle, and they were buoyed, Charles, by a big second half that put this one on ice.
So you get the sense that whatever was said at halftime obviously hit home. I think it's a little bit more than that, though. Obviously, there are words that are said, and hey, come on, guys, we have to play better. But sometimes it's just sharpening your execution, sharpening your focus, and maybe doing the things you practiced all week without major adjustments, just doing them better. And that got it done in this one.
So for the Seahawks, it's an ideal start as they move to 3-0 now on the young season. And they'll get another road test next week as they have to go to Santa Clara to take on the 49ers. Meanwhile, for the Vikings, the early struggles continue as they'll sink to 0-3. And they'll try to make amends next week as they host the Cleveland Browns.